In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up an online booking system for a remote group class using Squarespace scheduling. We start by assigning a teacher schedule, syncing your calendar, integrating with video conference software, and activating payment for class bookings. Make sure you stick around till the end for a customer booking walkthrough, including the email confirmation views. So it's worth noting I'm using a yoga group class for better lesson context, but the same scheduling system works great for any appointment business. Okay, step one is sign up for Squarespace scheduling. Before we kick things off, I want to remind you Squarespace scheduling works without a Squarespace website. So for only $14 a month, if paid annually, you can operate a full booking business. However, if you might need a future website, including a blog for content marketing, it's great to know it's only an additional $12 a month and just one click away. The three-step onboarding is wonderfully simple. Let's take you through it. Part one is your business info and category. Here I input Diane's weekend yoga, as this is a remote side hustle as she has residency at the local gym in the week. For industry, I input yoga. Part two is appointment type. We name ours yoga class, setting the price at $20 per 60-minute class. Part three is setting up the time slots. These can be customized in detail later for a class, so don't stress too much at first. For Diane, she likes to keep her weekend afternoons open, so assigns two classes per weekend, Sunday 9 a.m. and Saturday 9 a.m. Note how we left the weekdays unchecked, meaning classes are not available then. Click Next, then click Get Started to populate the calendar based on your settings. You now find yourself at your calendar dashboard with your friendly walkthrough setup status at the top and the calendar preview and settings below. Step two is calendar settings. Proceed to name your class and add a brief description. For location, I'm adding remote as they are conducted online via video conferencing software. I'm skipping images. We only have one calendar for this tutorial, but if you have multiple calendars, add different images to differentiate the classes. And finally, I add my email address for the booking notifications. Hit save top right. Next up is defining our appointment type as a group class. Head to the scheduling main navigation. Select appointment type out the lower menu options. Now click the edit button next to your class. Now scroll down and check this is a class or group event. Diane likes an intimate yoga class, restricting the booking limit to 6. So at $20 a student, that's $120 per fully booked class, and at 2 classes per weekend, that's potentially a great weekend side hustle at $240. You'll notice a new offer class button. Let's start by adding our Saturday classes. Yoga starts this Saturday, so we'll select the next Saturday within the calendar with a 9 a.m. time slot. To extend the booking availability, let's populate the calendar every Saturday for the next 2 months. That's about 8 weekends. Now add times. Note all the newly created Saturday group classes at 9 a.m. Now repeat exactly the same for Sunday. Select the next Sunday you would like to start classes, 9 a.m. time slot, recurring for 8 weeks, and then add times. Excellent. Note the Saturday-Sunday combo weekends for the next good while. Next up is customizing the appearance of the scheduling booking page. There are two different monthly and daily views. For Diane's weekend-only use case, we only want to show the day view to arrange the calendar by the very next available slots. If your booking was high demand and needed months in advance to book, we'd choose monthly view. Business name we set earlier. For the logo, Diane uploads an image of her in her classic yoga pose. For the description, we'll remind the potential student classes are limited to only 6 people and take an hour, adding a friendly message at the end. All the rest looks good, let's save changes. To get a bigger view of the booking page, click the View Live button. Yeah, this is looking clean. Note the intro description followed by a clearly laid out calendar. Next up is calendar syncing. We have options for Google Calendar, iCloud, Outlook, and more, but Diane wants to use Google Calendar. Simply click the Connect button and follow the steps. We're now prompted to confirm the calendar along with some additional settings. Diane would like a reminder 60 minutes before the yoga classes start. Hit save. As the settings save, the onboarding system now suggests if we'd like to enable Google Meet Hangouts to facilitate these yoga classes. Diane loves Google, so we'll proceed, but it's worth noting that if Zoom is your preference, simply set that up in the integration section of the main menu. Next up is customizing the booking confirmation emails. There are only a few minor edits needed to personalize the system a bit. Diane changes new appointments in the email subject line to new yoga class, and within the email body, yoga scheduled, ending with a friendly but motivational sign-off by Diane. Next up is setting up payment. Diane has a Stripe account linked to her bank account, so connects the Stripe integration in a handful of easy steps. It's worth noting at this point, Squarespace does not take any cuts in your students' payments. The full payment goes straight into your Stripe account. I want to quickly mention here, Diane doesn't need to add a pre-class questionnaire, but if she did, you do so with client intake forms. These are great if you use Squarespace scheduling for consultations and need to prepare a little bit. Okay, before we head to the last step of creating a class booking share link, Diane wants to create some free coupons for her close friends. Head back to the appointment type section and select coupons in the left navigation. Diane creates a friends coupon, taking 100% off the fee with unlimited uses. It's good to know coupons can be adjusted or removed at any time. The final step is to share your booking page. Squarespace Scheduling has a neat option to create a memorable short domain. Note the other options we have to embed the booking form in our existing sites. So before we take it all for a spin, I want to quickly remind you that for only $12 more a month, you can have a full yoga studio website with resourceful blogs for content marketing. In this website, you would seamlessly integrate this booking form using Squarespace appointment content blocks. Okay, let's take it all for a spin from the customer's point of view. When visiting the memorableshort.me link, we are presented with the clean booking landing page. We would like to book this Sunday at 9 a.m. Now your customer, or in this case your friend, proceeds to enter in their name, then their email, and redeem their friend's coupon for 100% off the $20 payment. When they complete the appointment, they are presented with a neat confirmation. Note how when we return to the page, there are only 5 available slots this Sunday. Let's take one final look at what the emails look like and how the meeting goes down. Here is the email to Diane for the Sunday 9 a.m. class booking with Rob Hope. And here is Rob's email from Diane with a personal touch in the footer and the link to the Google Hangouts Meet. The client simply kicks off this link on Sunday at 9 a.m. and waits for Diane to start the yoga class. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to set up a remote class booking system using Squarespace Scheduling. What a brilliant bit of software for only $14 a month. And don't forget, Squarespace has been kind enough to give One Page Love readers the exclusive coupon OPL10 for 10% off your first website or domain purchase.